CIET NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So let's join in Dhwani Shala class 8.
Hello children, how are you? I hope you are enjoying your time in activities, you are staying at home, but I'm going to expect you happy and peaceful. Myself, Vinod Bala, I'll be your team member for this chapter today. I'll take NCERT class 8, chapter 2, linear equations in one variable. I know you are just going to listen radio programs nowadays, you are watching TV, you are attending online classes, you are just going to face challenges also, because many times you don't have, you know, net. No problem, we are just going to overcome all these challenges. Now enjoy this program. Let me start today's class by taking a riddle. Listen carefully. Imagine one number. Yes, everyone imagine one number. Add 20 to twice of this number. Let me repeat. You can write down, pen down also. Add 20 to twice of this number. Divide the total sum by 2. Whatever is the result, subtract the original number from this result. What are you going to imagine? What is left with you? Just tell me. Let me tell you, you are left with 10. Are you surprised? Is it not interesting?
Yes, it's very interesting. Let me think. I need some time. Oh ma'am, you please tell me.
Okay, no need to worry. We are just going to do this riddle on paper. That will be better. So let us imagine the original number as P. Now we have to add 20 to the twice of this number. Twice of this number will be 2P, and we have to add 20 to it. So we just got 2P plus 20. We have to divide it by 2. Be careful children. The entire sum 2P plus 20 is divided by 2. After the division, we got 10 plus P. You can just write down in your notebooks. Subtract the original number from it. Original number was P. From this number 10 plus P, we have subtracted P. After subtracting P from 10 plus P, we are left with 10. Is it not interesting? Have you got it? It is very interesting. Now let us think for more such situations. The very first situation is the real life example we are just going to discuss. Listen and then pen down also. Ratio of present ages of Uday and Vani is 6:7. The sum of their ages is equal to their mother's age, who is 52 years old. We need to find their ages. Is the situation clear? In these type of situations, first we are just going to read the situation again and we are just going to plan what is given and what we need to find. Given is the ratio of the two children, Uday and Vani's ages, that is 6:7. And their total sum is given to us, that is 52. We need to find their present ages. What are we doing? We are just going to start with ratio. Since the ratio of their ages is 6:7, let us assume the present age of these two children, Uday and Vani, as 6 years and 7 x years. 6 x years and 7 x years, because the ratio is given to you. Now let us try to form the equation. We are just going to compare the sum of their age is 6x years plus 7x years with 52. So the equation is 6x plus 7x, 13x is equal to 52. This algebraic relationship is known as a linear equation because it is 1 degree equation. With the help of this equation, we can get the value of x. This 13 on the other side will be in division and the value of x will be known to us, that is 4. Once x is known, we are just going to substitute x back in 6x. That will be age of Uday. 6 into 4, that is 24 years. Okay, tell me the present age of Vani, because x is known to you and you assume the age as 7x. It will be 7 into 4, 28 years. See children, you can verify your answer. If you are going to add 24 and 28, you will get 52. Yes, it's very interesting. You explored like anything today. Now, it is time for us to develop understanding about equations. What are equations? Equations are the relationships between variables and constants. But mind it, equal to sign should be there. Without equal to sign, we have just the algebraic expression. Let us take some examples. Keep your notebooks and pen ready. Note down these examples of equations because we will be in need of these examples when we are just going to classify these equations. The very first example is 2x is equal to 5. 2 is constant, x is variable here and equal to sign is there. So it is an equation. You can number this equation as equation 1. Write next example. X plus y is equal to 7. Name this equation as equation 2. Yes, note down third example also. X plus y plus z is equal to 20. Fine. Number this equation as equation 3. Next example is x square plus 2x plus 3 is equal to 0. This is equation 4. Next is x cube minus 1 is equal to 0. Number this equation as 5. Next, listen carefully. X raised to power 4 plus 2x cube plus 5x square plus 7x plus 9 is equal to 0. Number this as equation number 6. Next is x square plus y square plus 9 is equal to 0. Now, let us ask ourselves why the name of the chapter was given linear equations when all these 7 equations are equations, but with the name this linear word is given. Are all the equations of one type or of more type? Think. All equations are not of one type, they are of different types. Let us now answer about linear equations. Here, this example 1, that is equation 1, 2x is equal to 5 is 1 degree equation. All 1 degree equations are linear equations. Oh, you have a doubt about degree. Degree is the highest power of the variable occurred in the given equation. In this example, it was 2x is equal to 5. Variable is only 1, that is x. Its degree is 1. So this is linear equation in one variable. If we observe the second equation carefully, x plus y is equal to 7. It is also 1 degree equation. So we will just classify this as linear equation in two variables because variables are 2. If we are just going to think for third equation, that is x plus y plus z is equal to 20. It is also 1 degree equation. So this is linear equation in three variables. But what about fourth? Fourth equation is x square plus 2x plus 3. It is a 2-degree equation. Hence, its type is quadratic equation. Let us think for fifth. Fifth equation is x cube minus 1. It is a 3rd-degree equation. Its degree is 3. So it is known as cubic equation. In equation number 6, its degree is 4. X raised to power 4 plus 2x3 plus 5x square plus 7x plus 9. It is a biquadratic equation. So on the basis of degree, we can classify. Now let us discuss about solution of an equation. Let us take the very first equation. 2x plus 5 is equal to 0. Tell me, what about the solution? Think. Fine. It is the value of the variable which satisfy this equation. What is the meaning of satisfaction? If in place of x, we substitute that value of the variable, then left hand side should be equal to right hand side. Now the question is, how to find the solution of an equation? Let us consider the equation. X plus 7 is equal to 20. We need to find the solution of this equation. Means the value of variable which will make left hand side is equal to right hand side. So in left hand side we have just x plus 7. I don't need this 7 here. What should I do? I have to subtract 7 from both sides. Left hand side is x plus 7. Let me minus 7 from this side. And right hand side is 20. Let me minus 7 from that side also. So I'm left in left hand side only x. And in right hand side it is 13. Is it clear? Yes. You can try some more questions. Pen down. First question for you is t by 5 is equal to 10. Solve it. You can verify the answer also. Second is 7x minus 9 is equal to 16. Solve for x and verify your answer. You will be very happy once your answer will be verified. In other situations, word questions are given to us. By just reading those word questions, we can just form the equation first, we can solve and we can get the answer of word questions. Let us try one word question which is given here. Listen the word question carefully. What should be added to thrice the rational number half to get 5 by 4? Let me repeat. What should be added to thrice the rational number half to get 5 by 4? What can we do? We can assume the number to be added as m. We don't know it. You can take m, you can take n, you can take t, you can take x, whatever you like, you can take that. The given number is half. Thrice of half will be 3 by 2. Now you can just form the equation 3 by 2 because it is thrice of half plus m. You have to add m, the unknown number. It should be equal to 5 by 4. In this way your equation is formed. You have to solve it. Keep m on the left hand side. Transfer 3 by 2 on the right hand side. You will get m is equal to 5 by 4 minus 3 by 2. Since the denominator of two rational numbers on the right hand side is different, take LCM, that will be 4, and simplify the numerator. You will get m to be equal to minus 1 by 4. You can verify your answer. You can just check. If minus 1 by 4 is added to thrice of half, you will get 5 by 4. You will be very happy. Now, let us take one more word question. There is a bag. In that bag, there are rupees 52,000. But only 100 rupees currency notes and rupees 500 currency notes are there. Ratio of 100 rupee currency note and 500 rupees currency note is 7:9. You are supposed to find the number of rupees 100 notes and rupees 500 notes. Let us just try to think about this word question and let us try to find the number of notes. How can you start? What is given in the question? Two things. What are those two things? The total amount, that is rupees 52,000, is given, and one more thing is given. Ratio of rupees 100 notes and rupees 500 notes, that is 7:9. So let us start with the ratio. Let us assume rupees 100 notes in the bag as 7m and rupees 500 in the bag will be 9m. Of 9m notes, each of rupees 500 will be 9m × 500. In this way, the total amount in the bag will be 5200m, that is equal to 52,000 rupees. The value of m from here will be 10. You are just going to substitute this 10 back to 7m, that is 7×10. Value of m you got as 10. 70 notes will be of rupees 100 in the bag and rupees 500 notes are 9m, but since the value of m is 10, you are going to substitute in 9m, that will be 90. In this way, you got 70 as rupees 100 notes and 90 as rupees 500 notes. You can verify your answer. Yes, children. Many times you have just seen the elder people just talking about all these word questions. We are just going to take the third word question, that is for you. You will just listen carefully. You will try. We are just going to discuss it. Salma is 7 years older than David. There are two children in this word question. Salma is 6 years older than David. After 12 years, the ratio of their ages will be 14:17. Find their present ages. How can you find? How will you start? Okay, you are just going to start with the assumption of age of David. Let the present age of David is T years. This T you can take any X, M, there is not any hard and fast rule. You can assume this as T years. Salma is 6 years older than David. So Salma will be T plus 6 years old. Ratio of their ages is given to you. Be careful. It is 14:17. So this 14 is a number which is smaller than 17. Without thinking, you cannot compare this with T plus 6 and T. 14 is smaller number. So 14:17 will be compared with T, that is age of David and T plus 6. You got one equation. Listen again. 14:17, I have written 14/17. That should be equated. That is equal to T upon T plus 7. You can cross multiply and you can get the value of T. That will be the present age of David. Let us cross multiply. 14 × T+6. That will be 14T plus 14×6, 84. And that is equal to 17×T. Then transfer 14T on the other side. You are left with 84 is equal to 17T minus 14, 3T. And this 3 will be transferred in the denominator. T, you are getting 28. Hence, the value of T is 28, that is present age of David. Add 6 to 28, you will get 34, that is present age of Salma. Again, verification is possible for you. Sarita shared her experience with me. Sarita is 8th class child. Nowadays, during lockdown time, she is just doing activities by her own. One day, she took the inchi tape and she measured the height of her all family members. There are 4 members in her family. The heights of 3 family members are 150 centimeters, 164 centimeters, and 156 centimeters respectively. We need to find the height of 4th family member. If the average height of her family is 160 centimeters. Okay, get ready and share. How can we find? What do you mean by average height? There are 4 family members in the family. See how creative is Sarita. Yes, you got the ideas. That's good. Let us assume the age of 4th family member as X. Now, we can set up the equation. We can form the linear equation. The total age of all the 4 family members will be 150 plus 164 plus 156 plus X. It is the sum of ages of all the 4 members. We need to divide it by 4. All the 4 ages sum need to divide by 4. You can equate it with 160. You can just set up the equation. You can write down the linear equation once again. 150 plus 164 plus 156 plus X. Entire sum is divided by 4 is equal to 160. Now you can just simplify it. This total sum will be 470 plus X by 4 is equal to 160. Cross multiply. After cross multiplication, we got 470 plus X is equal to 640. Let us shift this 470 on the other side. X is equal to 640 minus 470. In this way, you can just calculate the age of 4th family member as 170 centimeters. Now, let us try to verify. How can we verify? Since the age of 4th family member is known to you now, you can add the ages of all the 4 family members. You can divide the sum by 4. You should get the average as 160. If you are not getting it, you can just recheck it. Children, I want to share one more thing. Once as a student, if I'm just going to keep myself at the student's place, and since I told you in the beginning of the class that I'm your team member, if I'm just going to frame the questions like we discussed 3-4 questions today, then I'll understand the concept, I'll just apply and I'll just solve. So that is also a good way to develop the skill of framing the questions. For example, in class 8A, there were some students in the beginning. We don't know. 20 more students got admission and 5 students got SLC issued. After NIV admission and SLC, now the total number of students in the class is 40. What was the number of students in the beginning of the class? Try and solve it. Likewise, you can just frame more word questions. You can develop the understanding and you can just convert the real life situations into word problems along with solutions. Children, by today's class, I want to convey the message to you. Many times students just they mug up the answers. They are just going to cram the solutions. They just want to reproduce. That is not mathematics. Mathematics is about understanding of the concepts, about the application of the concepts in real life situations, about understanding. Like many times we have seen, whenever we are just going to ask Rajmistri, okay, you just tell me the number of tiles which I need just to cover up the floor of my drawing room. He is just going to calculate so fast and we are surprised. Are we thinking in that way? The process is important. The real life examples are important. Message from today's class is just develop the understanding. Explore the ideas, not to cram the answers. Did you enjoy? Okay, thanks a lot. Good day. We will meet again. Thank you.
You are just listening to curriculum-based programs, Dhwani Shala. Production assistants, Meenakshi Kukreti, Tanu Gupta and Jagbandhu Jana. Recorded by Bati Langlingdo and produced by Vandana Arimardhan. This program was brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.